Hello, fellow stampers. This is Yana Smakula for My Favorite Things. Welcome back for another video tutorial. In this video, I have a faux watercolor floral card created with the help of heat embossing and Copic markers. It's a simple project and one that anyone can make. Let's jump right in. I've started to work on my card by prepping the paper. This is Nina Solar White 80-pound cardstock, and I prepped it for heat embossing. I've treated the paper with anti-static powder and used a dry brush to spread the powder on the paper to remove any static and deactivate the oils or grease from my fingers. Not that I start making my cards with greasy fingers, but you know. I have the panel inside my Mini Misty stamping tool, and I also already have the stamp mounted on the lid of my Misty. This is from the freshly picked Bouquet stamp set. I'm going to ink up the stamp with clear embossing ink and stamp it onto the paper. This is a very beautiful spring-like floral bouquet. The next step is to add embossing powder. I used gold embossing powder from my stash and I generously covered the paper with it. It's been ages since I've last done this technique and it feels so good to go back and revisit it. I need to do it more often. Next, I'm using my heat embossing tool to melt all of that powder and heat set it on the paper. The embossing powder will not only give us a beautiful gold shine to our finished card, but it will also create a raised edge to our image. This is very useful in watercolor as it stops the water, and hence the pigment, from going outside the line. So if you're coloring a section, the embossing helps contain the liquid inside that section. We won't actually watercolor this piece, but having that raised edge sort of adds to the overall illusion that this image is watercolored. Now we are ready to color. I'm going for a faux watercolored look, and this means I need to add color to the base of the image, for example, at the base of the petal, and leave the tip of the petal nearly white, gradually spreading the color across the entire area. It sounds more complicated than it really is. It's actually very easy to do, and there's just one trick you need to remember. You need to not apply color to the entire section you're coloring. I know this sounds a little bit tricky and complicated, but believe me, as I start coloring, you'll see what I'm talking about. Of course, there are some exceptions, such as the flower centers here and also the leaves. I'm using Y35, Y08, and Y11 markers to color the center of these flowers yellow. Next, to color the petals, I'm using a very light blue. This is B000, and I am only going to add color to the tips or to the base of the petals, and I will flick it away, gradually fading it into white. This gives these images that faux watercolored look. It looks as if you added a dab of water and a little bit of pigment at the base of the petal, and then the water and the pigment gradually spread to the tip, completely fading into white. Looks very pretty, I think. And that gold embossing, that adds a lot to the overall look. I'm going to do the same with the leaves, but I'm not going to have the color fade into white. I will instead have it fading into light green. Starting with the darkest green, this is YG17 in my case, next using my medium green, YG03, and finally fading the color with the lightest green marker, YG01. Next, I'm going to color the rest of the flowers pink. For this, I have several colors. RV00, this is my lightest pink, and I'm flicking this color from the base of the petal towards the tip of the petal. Normally, when we color, we would use the lightest color to apply it across the entire section we're coloring. In this case, we're just flicking the color from the darkest sections towards the lightest sections, but we're not actually coloring the entire section using the lightest color. So this gives a nice pale pink tint to these flowers, still keeping the tips of the petals white. Next, I'm using RV10 and doing the same thing, but flicking it not as far deep into the petal, concentrating this color more around the base of the petals, creating shadows, and then adding it to the petal folds. Next, I go back to the RV00 and I reflick this color, helping that previously slightly darker pink, the RV10, blend better into the paper. At this point, I remembered that I forgot to color the stems, so I quickly did that using my green markers. I used the same colors as before, And I also colored the large leaves green. That helped me see the overall picture and decide if I wanted to make my pink flowers darker. So I went back to my pink flowers and I added a much darker pink at the base of the petals using the RV09 marker. I blended that out using the RV11, RV10, and then finally, once again, using the RV00. And I did use my flick style coloring method, flicking the color away from the base of the petal. This helped to add more color and also shape each of the petals, making it more lifelike. Very easy. It's not a complicated way to color. It's actually very easy. You just flick the color away from the base of the petal. With that done, I went back to my green markers and I reapplied the color to intensify it and also to intensify the shadows on the leaves. This doesn't take long, yet it adds a lot more contrast to the image and it helps it pop. And here's a look at the finished colored piece. I used a coordinating die and I cut the floral bouquet out. Next, I stamped and heat embossed several butterflies from the Spread Your Wings stamp set as I wanted to add several butterflies to my card. And I feel like these two stamp sets go so well together, the floral bouquet and the Spread Your Wings, they complement each other nicely. I used B02, B00, and B000 markers to color all of the butterflies blue. I wanted them all cohesive. I didn't want to introduce any other colors onto my card. And the blue matched the coloring on the light blue flowers that I had in my bouquet. I also used coordinating dies and cut the butterflies out. With all of the parts and pieces colored, we are now ready to assemble our card. Here I have a panel of light blue cardstock, and this will make the front of my project. I love to use colored cardstock as this is one of the easiest way to add color to a card. If you use a white card base, it will still look pretty, but having that pop of color, it really changes things up. I pre-blend the sentiment placement and heat embossed it in white embossing powder in the top left-hand side section of this panel. Now, if you decide to go with a white card base or a white card front, you could heat emboss the sentiment using the same gold embossing powder. I die-cut 4 blank bouquet pieces from white cardstock. There's no stamping there. These are just blank die-cuts. And the idea here is to stack all of these together, glue them together, and use them to create dimension on the card. Now, you can use foam adhesive squares, which would make it a lot easier, and they would also make your finished card a lot lighter for mailing purposes. But I really like the heft the cardstock layers add to the card. They add a solid layer of dimension, and that prevents any sagging from happening. Now, you can also use fun foam instead of cardstock and die-cut 1 floral bouquet shape from white fun foam, if you like. I am quite into die-cutting cardstock layers these days, so that's why I went with this technique. I used my Barely Art glue, and I adhered all of the layers together, and then finally I adhered my colored die cut on top, and then adhered that onto the card, framing the sentiment on the left. I love how this bouquet curves and encompasses that sentiment. It looks very pretty, very natural. I also added my butterflies around the floral cluster. I shaped the wings of the butterflies a little bit to give them a bit of a curve, and then I used foam adhesive squares to adhere the butterflies in place. So the butterflies are popped up a little bit, and then the wings are also curved a little bit, adding more dimension to this project. Finally, I embellished my card with some clear sequins, and I called it done. I hope you picked up a few tips and tricks in my video and will give this idea a try yourself. If you do, you guys know the drill. Please share online and tag us on social media. We always love seeing what you're making. Subscribe now and do hit that bell icon not to miss any new card making tutorials. Thanks for watching. Love you guys, and I'll see you next time.